guys doing? Hope you're going to have an awesome day today, Arrowverse here. Right now, we're about to do a recap, then a breakdown trailer for The Flash. All right, let's do a recap, shall we? All right, first off, we see Barry is all home alone. Now, he gets a text message. Well, he forgets to check his phone at night. It's a message from Iris saying that she's going to pull an all-nighter. So, he goes to her office to surprise her for her breakfast. But finds out that she's not even there and her phone is still inside her purse. That means Iris is missing. So he contacts the rest of Team Flash. Chester, well, he checks around the whole globe, the Earth, and there's no sign of Iris either. Cecile is also trying to sense Iris, seeing she could have any emotions, but she can't sense her at all. She's like blocked, not even there, disappeared. So she says she has an idea. Meanwhile, Marcus is declining Katie's offer because Katie wants to bring the dead back to life once again. I know, we just had an incident with Ronnie and now she wants to bring Frost back. So in Coast City, Barry actually finds a meta, and this meta, well, let's just say that she doesn't really want to help out Barry find Iris because last time she was with Iris, she made her mother disappear out of thin air. Yeah, she still holds a grudge against Barry, Iris, and Sue for that. Then Barry sees everyone frozen inside the coffee shop, which can mean only one thing. Someone is trying to reach out to Barry, which is the Steel Force, Dion. Now, Dion is still in pain. He tells Barry not to touch him. He says he knows that Iris is, well, she's disappeared and he could help save her. So Barry talks to Team Flash and most of them agree on you're going to have to go inside the Steel Force to find Iris and bring her back home. Now Barry's waiting for Dion's speed lab and Dion's telling Barry where we're going, there's going to be some crazy stuff you're going to see. So stay with me and stick to me and let's do this. So once they're in the Steel Force, Barry realizes that, yes, things are really crazy inside the Steel Force because he sees a newspaper that says Zoom and Godspeed destroying Central City. So Dion tells Barry, the Steel Force is mixed with the past, present, and future all combined together. So stay straight and let's keep an eye on this GPS tracker to find Iris. They do find the meta's long-lost mother, but she's corrupted and infected. Dion's trying to explain to Barry that we can't help her. We need to find Iris first. Meanwhile, Christian Kramer called up Chester because apparently in a halfway house, someone invented a decommacler. I guess it was supposed to be a bomb. 37 people nearly got killed. It has highly deadly radiation symptoms inside of it. Chester, he knows exactly what it is, so he says that he's going to take a good look at it in his workshop. So that's a mystery right there, but we'll find out what happens next. So Dion finds the tracker he placed inside Iris. Dion betrays Barry by, well, disappearing, and Barry tries to run after him inside the teleporter, but Barry's trapped inside the Steel Force. Back in 2049, we see Nora. Nora is actually a journalist, just like her mother. So she's trying to write an article, but Dion ends up kind of tricking her and teleporting her where Barry's at. He says, Nora, Barry needs your help. So Nora gets teleported into the Steel Force, and she finds Barry. Both of them, two heads are better than one, I'd say. So they do have a really good idea of how to get out of there. Meanwhile, Chester is obsessing with this device, saying that I created this device, but someone also created this because they watched me create it on live stream and I don't know what's going on. So, other than that, back in the Steel Force, they're about to, well, technically Barry's about to tamper into the Steel Force. Yes, that's Barry's idea. Courtesy of Wally. Wally taught Barry and I believe Nora how to meditate and to get deep in contact with the forces. They're able to get in contact with Joe only a little bit. Then Barry was out of his trance and Barry says he was able to send Jesse, Wells, Harry, even Nora's wife. And Nora said, I have a wife? Who's the lucky lady? Oh, wait, please don't tell me. And then they finally were able to escape because Barry has the Steel Force inside of her. Nora was the key. Nora has a spark of the Steel Force inside of her as well. So they're able to push through Memorial Park, through the teleporter, and out the way they come through the speed lab. Yes, they finally broke out the Steel Force, which was actually pretty hard. They tried doing it 3 times. Other than that, they're back in 2022, but Nora, she has to go back home in 2049 to protect Central City. Barry says to Joe, wherever Iris is, I can sense her and I feel that she's all right. Now, I guess she's calmed him down, Chester, and they're going out for a root beer, but someone's hacking into Chester's computer mainframe, downloading all of his files. Okay, now Marcus comes back to see Katie. He confirms her offer, says, okay, yes, I will help you bring Frost back to life. But you have to promise me something. We won't fail. And Katie says, I promise. So, I believe it's time we do a breakdown trailer. Are you guys ready for this? This will be a solo story of Barry. Yes, I'm gonna explain it why it's gonna be a solo story of Barry's. You guys ready? It's time for the breakdown. Let's dive right into it. The Flash Season 8, Episode 16. All right, Barry's new player on the board is an evil scientist. Well, we can never get over evil scientists, can we? So this evil scientist has a little, I guess you could say, trump card up his sleeves. So Barry zoomed around Central City because he got infected by this parameter. I have no idea what this parameter is, but it rapidly decreased Barry's cells. I'm not sure if any of you know this, but Chester technically says to Barry, you age 30 years overnight. Technically, speedsters age really differently, just like Kryptonians. They age like at a slower rate, but Barry's aging quite faster. Just to let you guys know, I'm pretty sure you guys didn't know about that right there. Speedsters age slowly, just like Kryptonians. So, we see a Season 7 bracelet back in action. So, Barry has to maintain his speed. So, whenever he uses his speed force, I suppose it makes him get older and more deteriorated. And Barry is starting to wonder, what if this is a symptom where it could be passed on to other people, meaning I may need to quarantine myself, or maybe, I guess, the doctor is the only key to fixing my problem. So Barry's having old man issues, meaning he could barely even run. His back is starting to hurt. It's tearing out, ripping him. His muscles, and it's really hard speed healing, especially when you're at that age. I'm not sure how old Barry will be at the age, probably like 60. Barry was in one place in 1 second, and now he's right behind Cecile, Chester, and Allegra. Crashes into the med bay and breaking glass, etc. The works, yes. His telemeties are off the chart, everyone, and yeah, I'm pretty sure that he will be fixed. All they need to do is find the scientist, capture the scientist, force him to turn Barry back to normal, his normal speed as usual. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys are new, subscribe to the channel as always, and yes, of course, I'll see you all in the next video.